The Hamming distance allows us to find the different bits into both the strings, just to check how different strings are or how similar two strings are. In other words, it measures the minimum number of substitutions required to change one string into another string that we have studied in edit distance yesterday. To convert one string to another string, well, then after conversion both the strings look like the same. The same fashion Hamming code also works. So in other words, you can say that Hamming code is used to measure the minimum number of substitutions required to change one string into another, or the minimum number of errors that could have transform where you transform one string to another string. In more general context, the Hamming distance is one of the several string metrics of measuring the edit distance between two sequences. So it is one of the form of edit distance, you can say. Where we can find the applications of Hamming distance in the real world? Whenever we study the coding theory, more specifically like block codes, when you want to transfer one block code from one end to another end, you might have studied encoding algorithms, right? So you do encoding on one end and encoding on another end. In that information transmission from one end to another end, number of block codes will be sent from one end to another end. There we can find the application of Hamming code, in which the length of two strings are vectors or a finite field given to you. The simple definition of Hamming distance is a metric for comparing two binary data strings. While comparing two binary strings of equal length, Hamming distance is the number of bits positions in which two bits are different. The Hamming distance between two strings A and B is denoted by D of A, comma B. It is basically used for error detection or error correction. In your subject DLDA, digital electronics, you can say, studied different codes. In that we studied the Hamming code. It is basically used for error detection and correction. The data is transmitted over the networks. It is also used in coding theory for comparing equal lengths of data words. Now, to understand how to find the Hamming distance between two strings, consider two strings are represented in binary like this. A has the data 10110010001, whereas B has the data 10010011. Make sure that when you are comparing two strings using Hamming distance, the length of the string must be same. The length of both the string must be same. If you see in this example, A and B, the total length of bits into both the strings are same. Now, the job of Hamming distance is to find the different bits into it. If you see, first bit is one and the first bit of second string is also one. They are matching, so we will not consider this. We will only focus on the different bits in both the strings. So if you see, the third bit of first string is 1, whereas second string is, it is 0. So here is the difference. Bit difference, whenever there is a bit difference, we consider that for the Hamming distance, calculation of Hamming distance. Now if you see the entire string, there are 3 bit difference. It is represented by the boxes, square box, right? So there are the errors, you can say, or there are the bit change. So we need to focus on the bit change in the entire both the strings to calculate the Hamming distance. Then how do you calculate the Hamming distance? Which operation is needed from digital electronics? Which operation allows you to find the difference between two bits? It is XOR bit. XOR operation we need to perform between two strings when they are represented by binary data. In order to calculate the Hamming distance between two strings, we perform the XOR operation, and it is represented by A XOR B. When you write a code, you can represent it like this, A XOR B, and then count the number of ones in the resultant string. Suppose there are two strings here given to where the output of the XOR is 1. You remember this thing. Whenever the output of XOR operation is 1, you have to count that. If the XOR operation of 2 bits is 0, then you have to ignore that. It means in XOR table, if you see, there are four for two variables, there are four possibilities: 00, 01, 10, and 11. So for 00, your output is 0. For 11, your output is 1. But for bit position 1, the output is 1. The bit position is 10, the output is 1. It means you have to focus on that. Finding the output of two bits where the XOR operation gives you the output as 1. So you need to count such occurrences. Now consider there are two strings given to you. That is the first string 1101, 1001. This is the first string, and the second string is 1001, 1101. So here, if I perform the XOR operation, your output must be 01000100. How it is? Check this. Take the first bit of first string and the first bit of the second string and perform the XOR operation. If both the bits are 1, your result is 0. So if you see the output resultant string, first bit is 0. Take the second bit of first string and also the second bit of second string and now perform the XOR operation on these two bits. So your output must be 1, because one bit is 1, other bit is 0. So for 10, the XOR operation or result is 1. So the output of the second bit is 1. Likewise, you can apply this to all the bits of this two string to get your resultant string. And in the resultant string, count the number of ones into it. That is nothing but your Hamming distance. Since in this result, it contains two ones, the Hamming distance is represented like this: d of string comma second string equal to 2, because we found that there are two ones in the result. Okay. Then how to find the minimum Hamming distance if there are many strings given to you? If there are several strings given to you and your job is to find the minimum Hamming distance among those strings. In a set of strings of equal length, and always remember that when you are comparing two strings, the length should be same. Then you will be able to compare those strings using Hamming distance. In a set of two strings or a set of strings of equal length, the minimum Hamming distance is the smallest Hamming distance between all possible pairs of two strings in that set. Suppose there are four strings given to you. That is, one is having the bits 010, another is having 01, next is having 101, and the last string is having the bits 111. In this case, if you apply the above formulas, XOR operation on these two strings, you have to first find out all possible combinations of these four strings. So the first possibility is 010 is checked with 011. Then we will compare 010 with the third string. Like this, I will compare the first string with the last string. Like this, the first three rows, if you see, we compare first string with remaining three strings, right? And in that, we found the Hamming distance by applying the above logic. And we found that the Hamming distance for first two string is 1. The Hamming distance between first and third string is 3. First and last string is 2. And so on. Now we'll compare it second string and with other fields, other strings. So second compared with third string, the Hamming distance is 2. When I compare second string with the fourth string, the Hamming distance is again 1. When I compare now third string with the last string, the Hamming distance is 1. It means we have covered all the possible combinations of two string out of several string and obtain the distances. Now we have to find the function. We have to find the minimum distance, Hamming distance. So we have to apply Hamming minimum function on this. You have to apply the minimum function on this resultant data. What is the minimum value in the resultant data? It is 1. That's why we can say that the minimum Hamming distance for the force is 1. It may happen that in your examination, it gives you the data in the form of a cube, and every point in a cube represent one string, suppose string information. So consider 3-bit binary cube for finding the Hamming distance. given in the diagram. First diagram, you see every point represents one string information, right? So in a queue, how many strings are there in this queue? So if you see, there are total eight strings informations are given to you. And how to find the Hamming distance between two strings? Again, you have to apply the same logic. You can suppose consider two string, that is 1 0 0 0 1 1. In these two strings, if I want to find the Hamming distance, so how many bit positions are changing into these two? This is 1 1 0 0 and another point is 0 1 1. In these two points, the difference between the bits is all the three bits are changing, right? So that's why the total distance between 1 0 0 and 0 1 1 is 3, whereas the distance between 0 1 0 and the another string that is having the bits position 1 1 1. Now check in the cube, this is the point which represent 0 1 0, whereas another point is 1 1 1. So what is the difference between these two? Only two bits are changing, correct? So the total Hamming distance for these two bits would be 2. The minimum distance between any two vertices is the Hamming distance between the two binary strings. So this is your second example about Hamming distances. Now we will see some few more examples. Now it may happen that the string may consist of characters, it may consist of word, or it may consist of digits also. The symbols may be letters, bits, or decimal digits, among other possibilities. For example, the Hamming distance between, now you compare these two strings. Suppose Caroline is the first string and the another is Kartin. Okay, so what is the difference between these two strings? How many alphabets are changing in both the strings? So it is represented by the red color. So you can easily identify that the distance, Hamming distance between these two strings is 3. Similarly, in the second string is, second example is again 3. In the third example, it is 4. In the fourth example, where there are binary bits given to you, the Hamming distance is 2, because only two bits are changing in these two strings. In the last example, where there are digits given to you, decimal digits, in that there are three bits are changing into these two numbers. So that's why the Hamming distance is 3. Now coming to the last example of this, it is shown graphically. The Hamming distance between two strings A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and the another string is B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So letter positions are given above. There are 7 letters. String 1, string 2 is there. And every time I am going to compare the bit position of first string and the second string. If they are matching, the answer is yes. If they are not matching, the answer is no. Now in this, both the strings, no string alphabets are matching. That's why the answer is no for all the cases. So if some of the alphabets matches, suppose, then your answer would be yes. That's why I can say that the Hamming distance for the both the string is total distance is 7. There are 7 alphabets, but no alphabet is matching. That's why the Hamming distance is 7.